10 Cats Does Countdown Christmas Special. Sean Lott. John Richardson. Kathy Burke. David Mitchell. James Acaster. Susie Dent. Rachel Riley. And your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to the 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown Christmas Special, a show all about letters, numbers, conundrums and Christmas. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. I'm not saying John's an unwelcome Christmas guest, but every time he opens one of the doors on his advent calendar, the chocolates pretend to be out. And John's teammate, David Mitchell. Christmas is David's favourite time of year because, well, you just try and imagine him in summer clothes. You can't, can you? Up against them this evening, it's Sean Lock. When I look at Sean, I think of Christmas because he has a face like a boiled ham. And joining Sean tonight is Kathy Burke. Kathy loves being on her own and doesn't see anyone on Christmas Day. Same as my nan, although my nan doesn't like being on her own. Sean, who would you most like to spend Christmas with?
Oh, that's a tough, tough question, because it's obviously a choice between Jesus, Santa or Pele, isn't it? You know, Jesus, it's his birthday, he doesn't want to be at my house. Nobody wants to be at my house on their birthday, not even my kids. Santa, he's knackered, he just wants to watch Moonraker with a can. You've got to spend it with Pele, which is great in one way, but he's taking so much Viagra now, he'll just be knocking all the furniture over. I wish you hadn't asked me. It's just a bloody nightmare.
Apologise. John, just quickly talk me through, what are you wearing?
This. I like to pick a horrific Christmas outfit each year. I think I really wear this well.
Nice. What's your Christmas morning routine?
It's similar to everyone else's, really. I don't eat meat. People always assume you have, like, a joyless Christmas, but I get up early and put the vegan pigs in blankets on, which is like carrot, but not peeled. Stuff like that. Luckily, marzipan is vegan. I have a bit
of that. It tastes vegan.
It's the recipe...
By which I mean it tastes disgusting.
Oh, I like it. The recipe is the same as the way I make love. It's roughly equal quantities of nuts and sugar.
David, what do you do to get into the spirit of Christmas?
Well, I'm a fan of advent calendars that don't have chocolates in, because I think that's a perversion. I like advent calendars to have a picture each day, and you can imagine what's it going to be in advance. Maybe it'll be a little child looking hopeful. Maybe it'll be Santa. That's a big day if there's an actual picture of Santa.
And you just like opening the window?
Yeah,
well,
it's a great build-up, isn't it? It's a brilliant build-up. 24 doors, and then hooray! Tomorrow we will have a row.
I think what you're saying is people no longer get sufficient excitement from opening a door and seeing a picture.
Yeah.
And that's kids these days.
Yeah.
they have too much time on iPads and screens, and opening a little cardboard door. And seeing something as simple as a shepherd's crook.
Yeah.
And a sword.
Yeah. It's amazing that it stayed at chocolates, that it hasn't moved on to crack cocaine.
Okay. Kathy, if tomorrow was your last day on Earth, what would you do?
Smoke. No, what I would do, I'd go to those places you're not allowed. You know, like when you're in a cafe or a restaurant and you go to the toilet. There's always a door, staff only. Well, fuck that, I'd go in it.
Yeah. Have a little poop in there, why not? So what's on your Christmas list this year?
Nothing. I don't like Christmas, you know that. I don't make lists. Why would I make a list about something I don't like? But I just find it abhorrent. I think it's appalling.
You think Christmas is appalling?
I do. I just hate the old caboodle. I hate all this shit. I hate that tree. How many trees does a studio need? Well, look, you've even got a little one there. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fucking trees. It's ridiculous.
I think it's in the 12 Days of Christmas. I think 5 fucking trees.
The only thing I do like, funny enough, is John's jumper.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I do, yeah. You know, like, Iceland does their party food range.
Oh, lovely, yeah.
So I brought out a range of my party food. And I'd like to start off with this one. Bun mushrooms. Right? Bun mushrooms wrapped in anchovies. And that's called prisoners in blankets. John would like this.
I'd love to, but I don't eat shit.
Honestly, they
don't
are
do
an absolute sensation.
Oh, no.
Rachel, you're usually game for these things.
I usually am, but I've gone vegan.
Have you?
In the last 5 minutes.
Sorry.
This is one of my favourites.
This is
liver with candy floss. And that's a pervert in playground. And that. Oh, well, you know when you've had a treat. Here we go, there's another one here. This is a mussel and a little cocktail sausage. And that's called pigeons on benches.
What is that one again?
It's a mussel and a little cocktail sausage. Oh. You should try some of these, Jimmy. I'm going to do you a little plate. We've got some other ones here. We've got widows on bikes. That's Brussels sprout with the poor scratching in between.
Nothing vegetarian then so far.
Well, that is. Oh, it's pork scratching. Come on. And I think, Jimmy, you'll appreciate this one most of all. This is it's a chip marinated in whiskey for 2 days, then lightly roasted in the oven and sprinkled with icing sugar. This is called Jocks on Smack.
Sean, could you not make eye contact with me when you're sucking a Brussels sprout? Because it's difficult for me to work aroused.
Merry Christmas, Jimmy.
Are you enjoying a widow on a bike there?
Yeah. A combination of textures.
It's all very funny now, Sean, but you've just had liver, candy floss, mussel, a cocktail sausage, some chips drenched in whiskey, two Brussels sprouts and a pork scratching. I think you might be sick, mate.
You haven't seen what I've been drinking.
OK, Kathy, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. I've got a food-based mascot as well. You know, it's a very health-conscious world at the moment, isn't it? It's all about exercise and being slim. And I've always been dead against that. And my mascot is carbs. And anyone want some carbs? It's very nice bread. I'll just do myself a slice.
What do you say it's called?
Carbs. Carbs.
I've not seen this food before.
And it's just lovely.
Nice. I mean, it's quite a thick slice you've done for yourself there.
Well, it's a comedy show.
OK, John, have you got a mascot?
I thought I'd take you on a Christmas carol journey through Christmas past, present and future. What with it being Christmas and all. This is Christmas past, so I thought I'd show the youth of today, what they call the on-demand generation, a slice of Christmas they'll never get to taste. And that was the joy of getting a Christmas TV guide and having to look forward to something that you were going to watch You couldn't just press a button and have it. You had to wait for these things. And if you were me, you'd record it. So this is one of my videos from my collection. I still have hundreds of these at home. It's got the film Legend on it, which I think everyone should own. And then an episode of a show called Fuck You, which was hosted by you.
Yeah, that's true, yeah. And are you saying that when you were still taping things, you were a child and I was already on television?
Well, no.
Is that what you're saying? Making me feel like Barry Cryer.
I thought you might like this because I don't think there's any record of this anywhere.
Oh, no, it was all destroyed. Well, thank you very much.
There you go.
Yeah, and I do, obviously, being from the past, I do still have a working VHS player.
The Ghost of Christmas Present. Now, this is Christmas presents that I've given to people that have been returned to me. At Christmas, you know, you get the thing where, like, if you like beer, someone will buy you one small beer, but then, like, a glass to drink the beer out of, all the paraphernalia and shit you don't actually want. I've got a friend who's a big fan of pickled onions, so I got him the Pickled Onion Lovers set, which is one onion there, a nice jar of vinegar, and In a Pickle, the History of Preservation in Britain. I think that's a lovely gift for the pickled onion lover in your life. That was brought back. And the final, the glimpse into Christmas future. What happens every year on the Christmas special is that I dress up like a Christmas tit and come all happy, and you two are always together, and you say that Christmas is shit.
Yeah.
So I've capitalised on that, and I now have for sale these, which I call Sadvent calendars.
Is that an abattoir?
It's a lovely abattoir scene there on the front.
Jesus, John!
Anyway, David, you'll be pleased to know, no chocolate in here. Behind each window is a lovely fact about Christmas that you can enjoy. For example, on the 17th, you'd open your little window and you'd read, "People are more likely to die at Christmas than any other time of the year." Four, someone chokes on turkey every year at Christmas. I think this is a gift for you two. Would you like to...
That's perfect. Can I keep it, John?
You can keep that. There's a fact behind every window if you want to have a look at a few bonus ones.
That's brilliant. Number six. About 350 people a year are hurt by Christmas tree lights.
You know, more people are killed falling downstairs than are killed by terrorists.
Let me write that one down for next year.
Terrorists find it very hard to get staircases through customs.
David, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I do. It's, well, it looks like just some nice Christmas decorations. But actually, this is Robot Wisteria. you know the plant Wisteria?
Yes.
It's a dangling purple plant, and this is the Wisteria that grows on the robot planet. It's a growing trend in Christmas decorations because obviously the aesthetics of Christmas and the aesthetics of robots have a lot of crossover, a lot of silver, a lot of gold, a lot of twinkly lights. The robot planet, they have that all year round. And a great way of getting our Christmas decorations and helping the economy of the robot planet is to harvest them from the robot planet.
Have you had a breakdown?
I don't understand why you're confused.
Where is this robot planet?
It's in outer space, Jimmy.
Wisteria tinsel, then. OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's James Acaster.
Yay!
What's the best Christmas gift you've ever received?
Dog. Got a dog for Christmas. And I know you're thinking, a dog is for life, not just for Christmas, James, but... I mean, this dog was just for Christmas, to be fair, but in my defence, it was 15 when we got it. The vet had only given it until New Year's anyway. And I was just there hanging out with it. I took really good care of it, probably the happiest month for that dog's life. Really looked after that dog. And then, I mean, it just went in the garden with all the other dogs I've had for Christmas. My garden is really...
Sure. Yeah. What's the top of your Christmas list this year?
Dog!
OK. And with James, of course, it's Susie Dent. This Christmas, thousands of people will be waking up on Christmas morning and finding Susie Dent's new book amongst their presents. So if you're watching charity shop owners, you might want to clear a shelf. Susie, are there any Christmas words that you particularly like?
Yeah, well, after all this food, it's got to be your Yule hole.
What's a Yule hole?
Yule hole is the furthest hole on your belt. Sometimes you have to make it, that's reserved just for Christmas. It's lovely, isn't it?
I thought, that's what I dig in the garden for the dog.
Well... I don't mean it. Oh, and this one for you, Jimmy, is a toe cover, which is a completely inexpensive but worthless present, like one of your DVDs.
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Yay! Rachel has a PhD in maths, physics and quantum theory. Using her to do the numbers on Countdown is like using Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer to pull a shopping trolley round Lidl. Rachel, what's Christmas like in the Riley household? Any Russian traditions?
Yeah, but they do have different traditions. Instead of Father Christmas, they have a guy called Ded Moroz, which is Grandfather Frost. And instead of Mrs. Claus, he travels around the world with his granddaughter. It's a little bit weird. But even weirder than that, we went to Iceland last year around Christmas. And have you heard of the Yule Lads?
Oh, yeah.
From Iceland. They're so creepy. They've got hundreds, I think, of these Father Christmases. And one of them is called the Window Peeper, one called the Sausage Swiper, and my favourite one is called the Doorway Sniffer.
So these are what? These are manifestations of Father Christmas, or...?
Yeah, they're called the Yule Lads.
Instead of a nice guy that gives presents, bunch of perverts.
And they are
Well, it's better than the Russian version with just a creepy old dude with a young lady wandering around the world.
That pretty sounds much like Doctor Who.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Christmas Turkey. It's the OK, let's count down, everyone, for the first time today. Sean and Cathy, you get the first pick of the letters.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Cathy.
Lovely, Rachel.
D.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
Ooh. P.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Would you like another one?
Oh, sorry. consonant, please.
And
sorry,
the last
Rachel.
One. N.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Dashing through the snow in one horse and sleigh. All the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleigh song tonight. Ooh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Arseholes. Cathy, how many?
Seven.
OK. Sean, how many?
Five.
Five, OK. David?
I've got a risky seven.
Playing dangerously. OK, John?
I think I've got a seven.
OK. Sean, what is your five?
Point.
Cathy, your seven?
Pointed.
Yeah, I mean... Sean, any thoughts on that? Mm. You got points, you just thought feet up. OK, your risky seven, David?
Patioed.
Patio.
P-A-T-I-O-E-D. It's when someone has been murdered and then under a patio. That hitchhiker very sadly got patioed.
And yet, it's not in.
It's not in?
Oh. No. Oh.
Is that the most recent dictionary?
John, you're seven?
I think I might have spent this wrong. It might be two E's, but I got pendant.
Pendant is very good.
Well, 7 points for both teams. Very good.
One, two, three, four. Oh, we've got seven each. Yeah.
Acaster, right. Dent, could they have done any better?
anointed. Oh. That's eight.
Anointed. Did you get that, James, or did Susie get that?
I got that.
Right, on to our first numbers round. John, David, you get the pick of the numbers.
What do you think we should say?
I think because it's Christmas, I'll say one big one, and then you say five small ones, but like five gold rings.
Oh, right, OK, yeah. We can do that.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, let's just pick someone at random. We haven't thought about it. One big one.
And then I say it like five gold rings.
Yes.
People won't think I'm a dick. OK, no, but I'll do it. I'm up for it.
One big one and...
Yeah.
Five little ones.
And I've done it in the shape of a ring just for you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, for Christmas.
Are you all whole?
Are you Right, we have 2, 8, 10, 8... 3 and 50.
See?
Fucking
and
useless.
The target. 785.
Okay, and your time starts now. John, did you get it?
Yes, I did.
OK. David?
No.
Sean, did you get it?
No. Sadly, I didn't.
OK, Kathy?
No, I was enjoying the brass band.
I don't want to suggest, Kathy, that yours is a problem of confidence, but I worried for you just when the 50 went up and you said, oh, it's just fucking pointless.
OK. John, how did you do it? How did you get 785?
I said 50 times 2 times 8.
50 times 2 times 8, 800.
And then 10 plus 8 minus 3 is 15.
Yep.
And take it away.
Well done. 785.
10 points to John. OK, so Sean and Kathy have 7, John and David have 17. And here is your teaser. The words are giant log. The clue is, it's nothing to show off about. That's giant log. It's nothing to show off about. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were giant log. The clue was, it's nothing to show off about. It was, of course, gloating. So John and David are in the lead. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for David and Sean. So, David, your turn to choose.
All right.
Can I just say something?
Yeah.
As soon as Kathy doesn't enjoy the numbers, shouldn't she do this?
That's a much better idea. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for David and Kathy.
What? No, I knew it was going to happen, but I'm trying to make it...
Yeah. I mean, you wouldn't normally react like that, would you?
No, you're right. Can we go again?
Sure. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for David and Kathy.
Ooh.
OK, David's choosing the letters.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, David. R.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
L.
Oh, it's no longer a word. This is going to get tricky.
Sorry.
Another consonant.
D.
Another vowel.
O.
And two more consonants, please.
And T and D.
OK, and your time starts now.
that hamstring. Oh, yeah, no, it's all right, you're getting better.
Yeah.
Oh. Should I be on a biscuit tin? OK, how many did you get, David?
Six.
Kathy, how did you do?
Seven.
Seven? OK, well, David, let's hear your six.
Dotted.
Dotted. Excellent. Now, Kathy, you're seven.
Related. No?
There's only one E.
What do you mean?
Sorry.
You were looking. You didn't say there's not two E's.
No, I wasn't playing. I
but just... you were.
6 points to David. Oh,
right.
And could they have done any better? Acast or Dent?
A lot of sevens. We found a lot of sevens.
A lot of sevens.
Rattled. Toddler. Rotated. We had a great time. And in between everyone, just saying how much we like each other. That was
nice. OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Kathy have seven, John and David have 23.
Oh.
Right, time now for Sean and John to go head-to-head. Sean, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'll have my usual,
your
please,
usual.
Rachel.
Thank you, Sean. Two large, four little. I know by now. And they are 2, 9, 5, 1, 75, and 50. And the target, 238.
OK, your time starts now. Target was 238. John, did you get it?
Yes. I hope so, because I spent half of that dancing. I'm going like a right dickhead.
It's pretty good, though. Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
Well, John, I think you better go first.
Yeah, I'll go first, and then Sean can say the same.
No.
Yeah, let's do it like that, shall we?
No.
Because, Sean, a lot of the time I notice when people get it, they put their pen down.
Yes. 5 times 50.
Yeah.
It's 250. Minus, you could take a 9 off that. And you've got another number, haven't you, Rachel?
Yep.
You take 2 away, you've got 239. We're quite close.
One
I
away.
I can feel us. What do we do? Do we take the 75 away? Or the 1?
Just whatever feels right for you, Sean.
I think we go for the 1.
Ooh. Correct decision.
238. Well done. So nicely done. You did it in the same way?
Did it in the same way.
Could you pass the paper over like they do on Proper Countdown? Because I think that's a lovely moment. Yeah.
There you go.
And then Sean.
I don't understand it.
OK, so it's 10 points to both teams.
Yay!
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. James, what have you got for us?
Jimmy, Christmas would not be Christmas without a little bit of celebrity gossip. So, fresh off the griddle. First name, Handy. Second name, Andy. Make noise, some of the Handy Andy fans in the room?
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't tell no one this. This doesn't leave this room. His real name is Handrew Andrew. This is hot goss, Jimmy.
Well, what else you got, baby? Dish.
OK. We all know the saying, ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. Little Ken Hom. He's trying to lodge a new saying. I cakes, you cakes, we all cakes for cupcakes. It's like he doesn't even understand why the first saying works. The moron. Plus, when he goes into Sainsbury's, he likes to shout out, I'm in Sainsbury's in the membranesbury's. Ken Hom shouts that.
And that's gossip, is it?
Yeah, and so's this. Nasty Nick.
From the first Big Brother?
Yeah. Also, side goss, real name, Nick. He started vaping. But, you might not think that's even gossip. Get your head around this. He didn't even smoke in the first place. One last bit of celebrity gossip for you in this section. Here's some Christmas goss. Noddy Holder, right, on that song, Merry Christmas, everybody. You know when he shouts out, it's Christmas, like that? He used to do that on every Slade song. It was just that this was the first time it was appropriate. I have to edit it out all the time.
James Acaster, everyone. The scores at the moment, Sean and Kathy are on 17, and John and David are on 33. And here is your teaser. The words are elf roast. The clue is didn't go down well. That's elf roast, didn't go down well. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were elf roast. The clue was didn't go down well. It was, of course, floaters. it's a card from Joe Wilkinson. I'm pretty sure it's from Joe. Dear Jimmy, I have a new job now, so you can stick Countdown up your arse. NASA have sent me to a new planet as part of an intergalactic exchange program, and in return, they have sent an alien in my place, so he's going to be on the show instead of me. If you have a problem with that, tough shit. Joe Wilkinson. Right, so I guess please welcome the alien we've swapped for Joe Wilkinson.
Hold on, let me turn it round. Hold on. All right.
So you're an alien from another planet, are you?
Yep, got a problem with that.
No, no, just you look a lot like Joe Wilkinson.
Yeah, I've heard that. I've heard we look pretty similar. Main difference is on our planet, we wear berets. Oh, and, we've got boobs. Prick.
Nothing, sorry. Do you have Countdown on your planet?
It's not as shite as this, though. It's actually quite good. You don't even have a Christmas bonus round, do you?
No, we haven't got a Christmas bonus round. Maybe you could show us your Christmas bonus round.
All right, well, it's usually played by the smallest contestant with the most annoying voice.
I think you might be talking about John Richardson.
Not me, surely.
Put yourself up here, sweetheart. Go on.
John Richardson, everyone. He's the smallest person with the most annoying voice.
God, he is small. Are you sure he's not a child?
Give me a hand up this step, would you? Come on.
Come on. Oh, there you go. There you go. There you
go. They look very real.
They look very real. Have a squeeze.
I mean, I've never touched a real one, so I don't know. I don't know if that's normal or not.
So, as I'm sure you're aware, John, on my planet, it's a Christmas tradition to shoot Brussels sprouts out your arsehole. So, for the round, I'm going to need my half brother Fabio to come. Well, come on, Fabs, come on. Oh, yeah, I should point out. If you're thick as pig shit, your boobs grow on your back. So basically, the round is quite simple. We're going to shoot Brussels sprouts from here, and John has to catch As many as he can. So let's play Catching Brussels Sprouts as they fire Al Fabio's bumhole!
OK, John. All you have to do is catch as many Brussels sprouts fired out of Fabio's arse in that hat that you've got on. OK, and your time starts now. In your head. Get lower, get lower. Much lower. Head forward, head forward. Head...
How do you get on?
It's not great news.
John, John, you get a bonus card there. You get a bonus card and you can play that any time in the game you feel you want to play it.
But we don't have bonus cards on this version of...
Well, that's a complete waste of time then, wasn't it? Let's play Countdown!
I just made that one.
Yeah, yeah.
Can I touch them?
Yeah, cut for your life.
They do look really real, don't they? It just felt really weird.
Don't feel weird about
I've
it.
I've never done this.
Don't you,
Dave? It's quite hot.
That's the noise I make.
Do you know, the noise of this... It's really loud. It's like grinding. I can't hear anything. Could just stop it fucking spinning.
OK, let's go on with the game, everyone. Sean, Cathy, your turn to choose the letters.
Consonant, please.
Consonant. Are you going to help?
Oh, yeah, I'd love to.
Do you know? There you go. Oh. I'll just pass.
And another consonant.
Ooh.
And another one, please.
C.
And a vowel, please.
That's an A.
And a consonant.
T.
And a vowel.
Oh.
Oh, that's good.
And a consonant.
H.
And a vowel.
You can't get it off, his fingers are too little.
And another vowel.
Small L.
And your time starts now. David, how many?
Four.
OK, Sean, how many?
Four.
OK, it's going to be a high score. Cathy, how many?
Five.
So, John, how many did you get?
Seven.
OK, David, what's your four?
I got this.
What?
I got this.
Well, tell
I
us
only
what
got
is.
This. This what? Is what I got.
So you could just read out what you got.
This is all that I got. I only got this.
Sean.
Gassy.
How are you spelling gassy?
G-A-S-I. As in, oh, this beer's a bit gassy.
Not with that spelling.
Cathy, you're five.
Coats.
Coats.
Yeah.
Yeah, inarguable.
Yeah, very good.
Coats.
Very Christmassy as well.
Coats?
Well, a bit Christmassy.
Well, go and get your coats. I want you to fuck off.
Sure. John, you're seven.
Goat-ish.
Yeah.
Something's goat-ish. Like a goat.
Yeah, you can be goat-ish. Yeah.
Goat-ish.
Oh,
God.
7 points to John and David. Could they have done any better in Dictionary Corner? What do you think?
Just another seven. We had gotchas for seven as well.
OK, so at the end of that, John and David are in the lead with 40 points. OK, time to go across again to Dictionary Corner. James, what have you got for us?
Oh, I'm reaching into my stocking. Ah, it's another hot griddle. Some celebrity gossip. Now, a lot of you have heard the rumour there's no such thing as Santa Claus. Here's the thing, celebrity goss, there's actually no such thing as Ricky Tomlinson. Not a real guy. Every time you see him, it's just someone else with a fake beard on. Yank it off if you ever see Ricky Tomlinson. Well, if you like that, open wide for some more. Fiona Bayan Brown.
Who?
She was she's the voice of Y-Bird on Playdates.
This is the hot off the griddle celebrity section of the show.
Fiona Bayan Brown. She's a rebel. When she has mouthwash, she doesn't measure it out in the cap, she swings it out the bottle. And I'll tell you what, before we go into this gossip, I'll tell you this. I hope Mr. Motivator isn't watching, because he's about to hear some gossip about himself. Mr. Motivator, this won't surprise you, actually, he invented Movember. Mo stands for motivator. It's supposed to be a month of being motivated, but everyone just copied his tash instead of his moves. And he got angry about it, and then him and his son, Little Mo from EastEnders, they started a campaign telling everyone, no, you're getting Movember wrong, no, and then they renamed it November in order to, like, you know, get across, like, no, you're doing Movember wrong. And that is why, to this day, we still call it November.
James Acaster, everyone. Very good. And here is your final teaser. The words are Elves Rod. The clue is get it all straightened out. That's Elves Rod, get it all straightened out. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were Elves Rod. The clue was get it straightened out. It was, of course, resolved. OK, time for our final letters game. John, David, your turn to choose the letters.
Could I have... should we start with a consonant?
Yeah.
Consonant, please.
M.
Should we have a vowel now?
Yes.
A vowel, please.
Yes.
Should we have a consonant now?
No.
OK, a vowel, please.
I just wanted to see if you'd listen to me. I know you've listened to
I respect the chain of command. Consonant now?
Yeah.
Consonant, please.
S.
Oh, Rachel, I've got your present, by the way. It's a tea tray.
Lovely.
It's so... just me, it's me draped over a Harley Davidson.
Your boobs look a little bit... Have you had a boob job since...?
All right, love, leave it. I've had a bit of work done, yeah.
So have you just taken my Christmas present away?
Yeah, your attitude stunk.
Consonant, please.
Kate.
Consonant, please.
F.
Vowel, please.
E.
What should we have now?
No, you finish this yourself. You
all right. Consonant, please.
N.
Vowel, please.
And O.
Oh.
OK, well, your time starts now.
I've got a four. Oh. Oh, it's going down my neck. That was really unpleasant.
John, how many?
Five.
Okay, David, how many?
Five.
Sean?
Well, I couldn't see. No, I'd like to play John's bonus card and have 20 points, please.
Kathy?
Five.
All right, well, let's hear. Well, who? John, you're five.
Well, you know, like, feck has become a thing. Well, in the north, we say fook. So I thought I'd have fooks.
It's not in, sorry.
Okay, David, your word?
Means.
Kathy, what's your word?
Monks.
Very Christmassy. Yeah. Unless they're Buddhist monks, in which case, very un-Christmassy.
Or chipmunks.
points to both teams. James, Susie. James, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, we have a really Christmassy word. We have nosema, N-O-S-E-M-A, which is a parasite that causes dysentery.
Here's a surprise. We filled that thing with them.
Yeah.
OK, so Sean and Cathy have 22, John and David have 45. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's pointless countdown conundrum. And your time starts now.
I know.
Oh, yeah, go on.
Astronaut.
Yeah. It is. Very well done. So the final scores are Sean and Cathy have 27, but tonight's winners with 45, John and David. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Christmas Turkey. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
And Jimmy is back on Boxing Day, testing how much some celebs know about what happened over the past 12 months. The Big Fat Quiz of the Year 2018 from 9 o'clock. And tomorrow night, a drag race like no other. Little Mix, Leona Lewis and Zara Larsson all join Courtney Act's Christmas Extravaganza from 5 past 11. Next tonight, Ted and Dougal in a Christmas special.